Hello and welcome to another Stack v Stack match. No tournament games this time, no weird events, just, and hey, no Testulus either. Just the Colosseum people, Honeycomb, and Main Branch. The test batch has been committed, that means Beam Destroyers are very deadly and very popular. In fact, they might be a little too popular. And it's overbringing Beam Destroyers is a good way to die. Team 1 ANS, Team 2 OSP, 3K 4v4, Team 1 DAS, Hellcringe, who is Hunter, Corbeau, Polymorphous Neuroid, Team 2 Vessel, Dramus, Duke of Stars, and ROM. Duke of Stars is a blue, it's a new person to the Discord and to these events. I haven't seen him before. It's always fun to see new people out. I think these teams are kind of ANS favored, but we'll see how this goes. Like OSP spreading out. Yeah, really spreading out. ANS focusing more on Echo side than Delta. Both teams kind of understanding the trap that is all inning on D point and trying to play in the cover. It's a good way to die very quickly when both sides do it and to lose any sort of strategic advantage that might have originally given you. As the game turns into a absolutely brutal brawl. Just being gabagools at this point. Waiting on ROM, there we go. Drop down with ANS? No, that's OSP. Need a Drive Plume Silhouette manual with playing cards deck. Right, let's go through these fleets. New stars! Plasma and containers? Ah, no. Empty. For tank. Plasma 100. And 250 plus PD, bulk freighters, two of them. Yeah, this must be kind of expensive. One LRT, I wonder what he's got in these. Gotta have two DCXs, right?
Looks like just the one.
These are so expensive. Anyways, on Dramus, we've got one plasma 100 mil, one 250 MPD, bulk freighter. EWR tug, rocket shuttle for camping. ROM's got one anchor bulk freighter in the plasma 100 mil style, but these are double-sided turreted. It's got PD as well all over the thing. Instead of a 250 on the roof to help with targeting. Interesting, a little different. And I have plasma and 100 mil turrets. Got a big ol' cap fleet, one LRT tug, one EWR tug, and a whole bunch of shuttles. Rocket, gun, and then one Nikki boy. Just thrown away at some point. Vessel's rocking.
ROM doesn't have Pavises on these, so they're just gonna eat total shit to the torp shuttles, or to the torp sprinters.
Oh, that's not good. Vessel's got double 450 bulkers, one LRT tug. And then some nearly naked shuttles, presumably armed with chaff and offensives. Yep. Corbeau's rocket and Axford. No one else has been Corbeau and Axford. Wait, what the fuck is this? Oh, it's my UI being broken again. Yay! Fortunately, that bug didn't get fixed in the patch. Corbeau's got. Oh, this looks like one of ROM's walkers, actually. Secondary 120s. Which is gonna pay off because OSP doesn't really have any missiles. And 450s and then one soft kill in the back, I believe. Yeah. A few offensive S1s too. And then two missile frigs with spyglass missile frigs. Alright. Hybrid and torps on them. DOS has. Xenophon was talking about earlier, a medium sized armada of torpedo and gun sprinters. Well, no, some of these don't have guns. Actually, I don't think any of these have guns. They all have. Yeah. The enemy
secured missiles. I'll be a double defender instead.
maybe Amon's, maybe offensivist ones, it's unclear. But yeah, that's bonk. Dead. And the beam finishes it off.
The enemy is securing
El Cringe.
The enemy is securing Hunter
has one of them. Okay. Missile and beam Axford, which is very nice. It's got torpedoes in the missile slots, of all things. Oh my. Very light on the damage control. Decent point defense. Girl in the front. United Spyglass Frigate, and then Torps Runner.
The enemy is securing zone attacks.
Polymorph Sneroid. Missile Jam Frigate with an interrupt on it, of all things. One Missile and Beam Destroyer. It looks to a Torps on it. No, those are S2 tubes. So S2Hs. Ah, two of these.
The enemy
secured
zone eclipse. The enemy secured
zone eclipse.
Same fleet
from last time.
Yeah. Alright, yeah. Big waste. Missiles getting soft killed by allied chaff. That's painful. That's a lot of missiles to eat that. EO.
I figured out why, Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Nah, I'm just surprised at the EO missiles. Yeah, continue.
So I figured out why Duke of Stars LMs are so expensive. It is because he brought a total of 163 AMMs.
Oh.
And they're probably command, would be my guess.
Yes.
And they're getting beamed.
Gonna help you if you're getting beamed in the face. Oh, and there goes the WR tug. Bye bye. How many APs you get on this thing, Chief? One. So it's just the one.
That is a lot of B shorting from Hunter for very little result.
Yeah, I killed the tug without any battle short, and it's gonna lose the beam almost entirely.
Although Axford, so I guess it will be able to get back up to like what from that 40%.
This is so nice, being able to mouse over missiles. Config, direct, act, radar, command validated. Very nice. Cheap frag, yeah, there go the AMMs. So the AMMs are command, can confirm very easily, thanks to the new spectator buff. Losing little cap sprinters. Duke of Stars continuing to survive upon the usual hell pit of Charlie. Is eating 4
although this
now.
One LM is in a real bad way after those torps.
Yeah. Don't have that many restores either.
Oh, it's restoring the large storage right now, so it'll have 8 okay. Or 7, I guess. Although Corvo is now shooting it, which is quite possibly going to just take it out.
Little engagement on Echo. ANS has lost a lot of their capping power. About a quarter of it. Looks like they're about to lose another one. Yeah, there it goes. Bye-bye. MVDD is covering Echo, but I don't think they're going to be able to cover it super effectively against Gramus's Plasma 100-250 Wombo combo. Yeah, Duke of Stars recognizing that he's in trouble and he needs to leave and leaving. This guy's like a lieutenant commander. He's still blue.
Yeah, top rank blue. Whatever that's called.
Awesome to see how the skill floor of the player base has increased so very much since I started playing. Some S1s. Oh, are those... These are active radar AMMs. Nice. Oh, Vastel eating quite a few S3Hs, but is fine? Like, ooh, this is fine. You can repair it a lot.
Buff module.
Did he? Ah, yeah, 1 AE. 10 restores.
10 restores on these fucking things.
Oh my god.
I think Das is being way too aggressive with these Torp Sprinters. He really didn't need to be, that's and now half of them are dead.
Absolutely. And they would have performed really well against the shuttles, played properly, but they got, well, two of them got obliterated by the bulk freighters on Echo side. They don't need to be having those in these long sight ranges. They're doing a pretty good job with the spy frigs keeping sight on everything.
And on the plus side for the AMS cap game, I'm pretty sure these frigates from Corbeau, if they got all of their shots off, they could probably kill every single one of the shuttles.
Yeah. It's the power of what is currently the one use of cruise missiles. Shuttles.
Oh, I think those are direct, but I don't know.
Probably. Still makes me sad. One of Dramus's liners eating some beams, but it's from the missile beam destroyers, and they've got more investment in the missiles. Oh, a few missiles punched through. Beams coming in, starting, the damage is really starting to stack up. Oh, yeah.
The enemy is dead,
it's dying. Oh, a little bit of a PID failure there. These are some very long stage range S2Hs. They have no terminals either. They just get there fast and eat their ass, I guess. It's been working. It's been punching through the AMMs. I'm not really sure how. Let's keep a close eye on this. Going for like a flanking shot. Oh, nice.
Oh, no.
Glonk.
Oh, wow. I don't think that was the intended target, but it is a good target.
Very good target. Damn shame only one of them hit. If both of them hit, yeah, that would have happened. It had to have been an intended target. Oh, no. Corbeau did the follow-up.
Yeah, I think the shot around the side, that was going for the Azurite, I think.
Sneak possibility. Bandy Youth about to eat two of these S3Hs. They're not HEKP. Man, I'm so happy with the spectator buff. Ooh. Still makes it through with one missile. Not amazing damage, but damage is damage. But he means to fire everything now. It's getting shot up by class 100.
Torps out, though.
They're headed for the beat up, Bohemite. Bohemite?
If he's hit, that thing is gonna die.
Yeah, and the flak is not gonna cut it. It gets one, it gets two!
I think they're out of range.
What the fuck? Oh, yeah. They're all exploding at the same spot. I was about to lose my mind.
I do get my single-fired Sprinter Torps killed by flak an annoying amount of the time.
Torps and S1s after the Bandy Youth, but this thing has a ton of defenders on it. Kill those, no problem. Briggs gonna need a ton of grape for its trouble and probably get critted and explode.
The enemy is securing zone dagger.
It's also been some 415 out too. ANS ahead by 110 points, but they're losing the cap advantage, or no, they're gaining an extra cap actually. I'm taking it back. Oh my.
So yeah, in like the last minute and 30 seconds, ROM has lost 5 shuttles.
Big freeze up there on land. Yeah, yeah, it's mostly the missiles, I think. What happened to you? It's a missile hit. Some more missile hits. Missiles. Oh, yeah, that's probably missiles. And that's two missiles as well. Yeah, all the missiles.
The enemy secured zone dagger.
What do I want? OSP in big trouble. Secondary batteries keeping control of Charlie. Probably has.
The enemy is securing zone common.
Very silly.
That 120 battery coming in handy there.
Indeed. Oh, there goes another shuttle.
Yeah, ROM really needs Pavises on these. They're suffering.
Yeah. Well, that was actually one of the Astles. Also, which do not have Pavises, they have soft kill on them instead.
Looks like Das thought that rocket shuttle was dead, and it was not. But they all get defended.
Yeah, my rocket shuttle eats a couple torpedoes for its trouble. Means some S1s. It's not dead dead, but it's gonna be a while before the graphite gets up and does anything.
That is the trouble with having not having guns though, is that thing is alive, it will be able to cap B because the buy-in curry is gonna get pushed off by the liner.
Yeah. You really need the guns to fall off on the sprinters. Bandy Youth getting a lot of missiles launched at it, but more importantly getting beamed. Well, this isn't doing that much. And defenders are doing it. Excellent job of killing the missiles headed for it. Oh, he ran out of ammo.
I don't think he ran out. I think the fire eight got too close and I couldn't shoot anymore.
Oh, maybe. Yeah. He is down.
Yeah, he's still got
9,000. So many rounds of defender. It's been working. Morphous Neuroid. Wish a plasma 100 for the trouble. Oh my, this. Oh yeah, right. He's got roasted by the shuttle explosion
the
over here earlier.
Securing zone dagger.
Damn. Operator coming into Cap Delta. So the graphite did get finished off by someone. Could have been more missiles. Yeah, I'm not seeing any bullet holes. Those are all missile shots.
Hunter Sprinter by D is out of missiles, so while it could normally pop out and absolutely destroy this bulker, it will not be able to.
I think, Corbeau's ship is gonna have to handle this. He doesn't have that many missiles in it left either. Oh, the Angstrom's getting shot at too. Bunch of missiles, torpedoes out of the Axford, headed for Vastel's ship. Oh no, this is Duke of Star's ship. It's protected by the million AMMs, but yeah, it's not gonna be enough. Couple get through. Defender doing pretty well though. Here comes a beam. Yeah, AMMs plus Defender working decently, but oh, beam killed. Kill the Pavis. All these are gonna get through, and now this thing's in big trouble. Oh my.
It's getting hit by its own AMMs, too.
Always painful. They don't do any damage, but, you know, the moral. The moral defeat. Look at the side of the ship. Wow. So, yeah, it's both of his ships dead. Quack Isle can technically come back, but it's going to take a long time before this thing's fighting fit again. Might wind up going nuclear, too. Dramus still valiantly fighting over Echo and getting beamed to death for his efforts. And it's up 250 points. We're starting to lose some offensive power. One of the missile beam destroyers is destroyed. The other one has it's got knocked out. It's plasma to hell, and it's probably about to be destroyed. Meanwhile, Vassal and his 450 bulk critters are fine and dandy. Able to dump out heavy firepower anywhere in the battle space very quickly.
The enemy is securing zone.
Whether or not that happens, though. Come on, Charlie's another interest absolute graveyard.
And, OSP has exactly two shuttles left.
And there goes one of the EWR LRT tugs. Meanwhile, ANS has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Four sprinters and, three frigates. Which would be not bad, cappers. One of these torpedoes coming in. Bonk. 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 Oh, that thing just got structure broken.
Torpedoes are so fun. I'm glad that they're actually, like, really good now.
Yeah. Yeah, we read about them in Balcon for, like, 4 solid months. And they got made good. It's pretty nice. That is one damaged ship and still eating more missiles. That's another ship that's out of the fight for the foreseeable future and maybe forever. Just needs a little bit of follow-up. Let's see, the 450 Axford's over here fighting the Bulkers. And the beam missile Axford is holding down Charlie. Das does manage to get a Bravo cap. Did that a while back, but. Just now getting to that.
Vastel's other 450 liner is just sitting back here on D, having to guard it from an empty sprinter.
Ooh, that's painful.
Which is a big waste.
Especially since it's full health. Bulk freighter getting deep fried by this beam. And it's out of restores. It's out of everything except for drive, mag, and Citadel CIC. It's not gonna be shooting.
It might be able to cap Evo if the other bulkers can keep the beam DD suppressed.
There is a chance of that. It'd be very silly.
Not that that'll help, but.
It's certainly a chance. Yeah, not particularly.
Another Valiatorps on one of Vestal's LMs.
It's already dead? Yeah, it's gotta be. The other one's well.
Yeah, it was the one that was already dead.
Unfortunate. I mean, there might be enough reactor crits cooking off here. This thing's just gonna burst.
Well, it could zombie. It has enough restores.
Well, problem is it's got 4 crits in the boosty reactor and 1, you know, nuclear crit. And then 4 crits in the long haul and 1 nuclear.
Yeah, then let's get scrammed.
Oh, yeah. I don't think he's paying attention to it anymore.
Yeah, I do that all the time. Where, like, I see a ship gets hit, I'm like, okay, I don't have to worry about that right now. And then it blows up because I wasn't paying attention.
Yeah. That's really there. Okay. Oh, SP recognizes it over. 500 points down. There we go. GG. Let's head up to the waiting room and see what the players think about that match.
Figured out the trick to beam stones. You gotta point the beams at the bad guys.
Hello, incredible.
I love how little damage torpedoes do to LNs.
I was about to say, I'm surprised you don't have more damage on the axe.
You did kill 3 LMs, it's just the damage numbers aren't that high.
Yeah, they don't match what you actually do. It's really funny.
Yeah, I mean, I spent 4 torps for 5k damage on a line. I think it's mostly overkill that causes the low damage numbers.
You get really high numbers with size 9 warheads, though.
I didn't get to use a single one of the max.
Oh, hey, old Tim, you are ready to go.
Old, you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I was remaking a cap
they
fleet.
Are kicking you.
Okay.
Alright, well, apparently there's another game going on in this lobby at the same time. Which is a little silly. Yeah, I'm gonna have to make even more fucking channels for this Discord. There are already so, I feel like there's so many already. The people are busy. They do be loving the Nebulous. If you're interested in participating in this madhouse, link for that's gonna be in the description. I think we covered basically everything during the match. Short version is OSP cap fleet was kind of questionable and very weak to the ANS cap fleet, which was standard meta for ANS and kind of lagging behind on OSP, and ANS won. Boom, boom, boom. Simple as. They also got a pretty solid military victory as well. Killed a lot of stuff and didn't lose that much. So both arenas handled very effectively by the ANS team. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Seeing the battle space, dear viewer,